You are listening to the IoT for All Media Network.
So let me ask then, when we're thinking of the application of this technology in certain industries for certain use cases, where have you seen kind of the most adoption, and where is it kind of, what is it really aimed at, I guess, from a target use case standpoint? Obviously, there are probably some use cases that this works really well in, and other use cases it has its limitations around. So give us a couple examples of how this can be used in real world settings for a different industry or use case that you all have focused on, just so our audience really can understand kind of the power behind what you built.
Sure. I will relate to a couple, although there are many. Turns out, you know, wireless power is for every IoT device. And if we want to look at the whole market, you know, Cisco predicts there will be 500 billion IoT devices by 2030. And that's a published report by them. Mm-hmm. So you're talking about that if we are going to put batteries in those devices, humanity doesn't build enough batteries for that many IoT devices, even if you disassemble every electric vehicle car battery and try to use those. So we're really way short of that figure. And if that's going to happen, if IoT is going to happen, it will require wireless power. Mm. Now, that means that we're using the people who need the technology are in every industry, you know, manufacturing, building management, smart cities, retail stores, infrastructure, distribution, consumer electronics. So what I'll do, I'll talk about retail stores and home usage. And that gives you an idea about
it. Okay, sure.
So in a retail store, you know, one of the most popular devices that we're seeing around in supermarkets and other retailers is the advent of the electronic shelf labels, little price tags that are electronic devices that are showing the price of the goods as you walk around the store.
Right.
Now, these require batteries today. And in a retail store, let's say one of the big retailers or supermarkets, you're going to have 30 to 50,000 of those devices, each one requiring three to six batteries.
Okay.
So if you think of that, that's 100,000 batteries in a store.
Right.
Where now, you know, and these retailers have like a, you know, let's say 5,000 stores across the United States.
Right.
So you're talking about suddenly you have 500 million batteries, right, that will last 2 years. So every year they have to throw away 250 million batteries.
Okay.
And that becomes a major sustainability issue, but also manpower. Turns out that the manpower you're saving somebody walking around changing the price tag for the, you know, whole milk today, doing it on electronic devices is easier because, you know, in headquarters, they can press a button, change the price. But if you want to change the batteries, you're going to spend the same amount of manpower just changing the batteries as if changing the paper price tag.
Right.
So this is where wireless power can come in. And not only power all those devices and never having to worry about the battery in the whole store, but also enable other sensors like people sensors, temperature sensors and refrigerators, even HVAC sensors in the environment that can save a ton of power. But the idea of having to put in, tens of thousands of devices sometimes around the store actually ends up with a heavy burden on cost or manpower. So that's a major solution that we have. Not talking even about the back end of the store, the distribution centers, etc. Now, in the home, we have lots of devices: our phones, our wearables, and so on. What we really need is a system that you set and you don't have to worry about it. So you don't need the one in every room. You need something that like Wi-Fi gives you good coverage. Although the power levels may be good enough for most of the IoT from room to room, to really get power enough for a smartphone or your wearables, you'd need to be in the same room. So you'd have to strategically place the transmitters in your room, in your house, to get the benefit of it. But after that, you know, how many times did you pick up your digital camera from the drawer and find out that you didn't charge it before you're going on a trip? Or, you know, or other devices like a flashlight or something.
Right.
The problem is that we have so many devices, we forget the count of them, and we forget that we need to maintain these batteries. We're not like an enterprise where we have people doing this for us. And wireless power would really improve our life, you know, from productivity, safety, health, even, and comfort. So wireless power will enable us to deploy many more devices. And I anticipate in our homes, we should reach about 500 devices in the next 5 to 10 years in our homes.